Give us your assessment. Is there a way out?
The war is a total disaster. It's a catastrophe, nothing less. It is such a shame that this took place. In fact, I gained a lot of respect for our current president's father by the fact that he had the sense not to go into Iraq. He won the war and then said, let's not go the rest of the way, and he turned out to be right. And Saddam Hussein, whether they like him or didn't like him, he hated terrorists. He'd shoot and kill terrorists. When terrorists came into this country, which he did control and he did dominate, he would kill terrorists. Now it's a breeding ground for terrorists. So, look, the war is a total catastrophe.
Who do you blame?
And they have a civil war going on.
Who do
there.
You blame?
Well, there's only one person you can blame, and that's our current president. I mean, obviously, Rumsfeld was a disaster, and other people that are giving him advice have been a disaster. And Condoleezza Rice, who's a lovely woman, but she never makes a deal. She doesn't make deals. She waves. She gets off the plane. She waves. She sits down with some dictator, 45-degree angle. They do the camera shot. She waves again. She gets back on the plane. She waves. No deal ever happens. So, I mean,
you got to close the deal at some point.
You got to make deals. The world is dying to make deals, and we don't have the right people doing it.
The Vice President, Dick Cheney.
Well, he's obviously a very hawkish guy on the war. He said the war was going fantastically just a few months ago. And, you know, it's just very sad. I don't know if they're bad people. I don't know what's going on. I just know that they got us into a mess, the likes of which this country has probably never seen. It's one of the great catastrophes of all time. And perhaps even worse, the rest of the world hates us. You go throughout Europe. I travel. I do deals all over the world. The Europeans hate us. You go to Germany. You go to England. You go to places that, you know, we didn't have problems with. They all hate the Americans because of what's happened. We had a chance after September 11th to be the most popular, for the first time ever, to be the most popular nation on earth, and we blew it. Everybody, for the first time, people felt sympathy. I'm not saying it's a great thing to have sympathy in terms of yourself, but for the first time, they felt a sympathy and a love for this country because of what happened. And we blew it.
How does the United States get out of this situation? Is there a way out of it?
How do they get out? You know how they get out? They get out. That's how they get out. Declare victory and leave. Because I'll tell you, this country is just going to get further bogged down. They're in a civil war over there, Wolf. There's nothing that we're going to be able to do with a civil war. They are in a major civil war, and it's going to go to Iran, and it's going to go to other countries. They are in the midst of a major civil war, and there's nothing. And by the way, we're keeping the lid on a little bit, but the day we leave anyway, it's all going to blow up. And Saddam Hussein will be a nice person compared to the man, and it will be a man. It will not be a woman. That we understand. People say, oh, gee, you didn't give the women a chance. It will be a man. Compared to the person that takes over for Saddam Hussein, he will be considered a nice person. This guy will be the meanest, the worst guy, and he'll have one thing, one thing. He will hate America, and he'll use that to flame. So, I mean, this is a total catastrophe, and you might as well get out now because you're just wasting time and lives. You know, nobody talks about the soldiers that are coming back with no arms and no legs. And I saw at Mar-a-Lago on Mondays, I make Mar-a-Lago my club that you know about.
In Palm Beach.
I make that twice now. On a Monday, I let returning Iraqi injured soldiers come to the premises. The most beautiful people I've ever seen. But they're missing arms and legs. They're with their wives. Sometimes they're with their girlfriends. And the tears are coming down the faces of these people. I mean, the thousands and maybe hundreds of thousands, and the Iraqis that have been just maimed and killed. This war is a horrible thing. Now, President Bush says he's religious. And yet, 400,000 people, the way I count it, have died, and probably millions have been badly maimed and injured. What's going on? What's going on? And the day we pull out, it's going to explode. We're keeping the lid on a little bit. It's still a catastrophe. But the day we pull out, because they're in a civil war, whether we want to admit it or not, they're in a civil war.
What do you think of some of these scandals that are unfolding in Washington right now? As we speak, the Attorney General is under fire, Alberto Gonzalez. What do you make of this as an executive trying to watch an administration?
Look, everything in Washington has been a lie. Weapons of mass destruction was a total lie. It was a way of attacking Iraq, which he thought was going to be easy, and it turned out to be the exact opposite of easy. He reads 60 books a year. He reads a book a week. That's, do you think the president reads a book a week? I don't think so. He doesn't watch television. Now, one thing I know is that when I'm on television, I watch. Or I try. Because you do. Your own ego says, you know, let's watch. Let's see whether it's good or bad. You want to watch, right? He doesn't watch television. So he's on television being interviewed by you or somebody else. He doesn't watch. Does anybody really believe that? Now they're doing this whole scandal with the U.S. attorneys. Now they're finding emails. And it's proven to be a lie. Everything's a lie. It's all a big lie.